So the session is being recorded. So this is important for you because later it's possible that they will be sharing this document online. So yeah, I don't know if there is some problem with you. It's okay. If you prefer, don't appear. You can switch off the camera and so. But just to let you know that we will be sharing the session. Okay, now let's share the presentation. So the idea is, I will be presenting the project. I guess you already heard something about this villa project. So I will be presenting a little bit more. And at the end, depending on the time we will have left, we'll try together to think sort of actions or references we can propose to go to action with the project. Okay, so I'm now try to share. The presentation. I hear a noise. Okay, now it's gone. Thanks. Okay. Okay, I guess you can see the presentation now. Okay, so let's start. So first of all, I would like to remember you that this session I was saying at the beginning is part of a bigger event called the Global Camp, which is the regular meeting that the Civic Wise Network is organizing mainly any year. Lately has been complicated, so this is the meeting we are organizing after 2 years, and we are doing now the meeting in online format. But in the past was on-site event. We hope soon we can have a new in-site event. So as part of this meeting, I shared with you in the chat so the link to access to the whole event. So maybe later, if you're interested, you can visit and be part of the other activity that are happening all day long. Then also remember that this workshop is organized by Volume, which is an company agency. We don't know yet how to rename this project that is changing. That work with creative and productive hub to create positive impact on city and territories, and the NGO Ville, which is an organization that just started in Marche region, where actually I am now and where the villa is. And we will know more about it later along the presentation. And I have here Cenk that is part as well of this organization. Cenk, you want to say some just to salutation and introduce you?
Yes, thank you, Domenico. I am the member who is not in the the European Union zone. So I'm right now in Turkey, in a city called Izmir. But Izmir shares the same sea, the Mediterranean, with Bari and all other European cities that has the coast to a Mediterranean city. I am an architect, and I am so happy to see you all and to have the opportunity to possibly work with you on. Yeah, that's all for now, Domenico. Please continue.
Thanks, Jack. Maybe we will have other members of the Ville NGO reaching out during this session. So maybe we will have the opportunity to meet more more people. So I think this is even I hope I would say this is a topic that create a lot of interest because I guess we don't have a lot of time the opportunity to think about how and what we can do in an Italian Italian villa. But to actually to get real, this action is really important to grow the connection and synergy with different kind of project and people, organization all around the world. So I hope this workshop will be also the opportunity to create these synergies and connection. Besides the you know the ideas and the information we can have during the session. So now you can see already some picture. So the idea is that we would like to. This is right now a private property because. Actually, the city council lost the property, the ownership. I mean, the ownership 50 years ago. So during this time, different owners managed the villa, and the last one actually, I don't know how to say in English, broke up. I don't know. It's for. Fell down. So now the villa is actually managed by judiciary organization. The villa is so in auction, and the let's say that they are trying to sell the villa in order to pay the debt that the previous owner created during the last years. So for us, it's really important that anything we can promote, give a new life to this villa and could understand the villa as a common. So you can see now more images. We will see some other pictures. I would remember so insist in this concept. So we can think at least at these three actions, which are buy, think, and operate. Actually, the first one buy is now maybe less. On the radar, we didn't really lose completely the idea to buy it, but it's more difficult now. We will see later why. But of course, we want to think together about what we can do in this villa and also operate what we are thinking in the villa. Why this? Because even if we will have other buyers for the villa, and we should say that among these buyers could be even the city council. We think that if we create a, interesting proposal, interesting consortium of people and organization, we can offer not only good ideas, but really the management and the, you know, operation of the, maybe if it's not the whole villa, part of the villa. And the idea is that to achieve that, it's really important to work on a different level. So we have, of course, the local level, which is the citizenship that are part of the city called Potenza Picena, which is really small. I think is less than 20,000 people. So it's really a small town, and this is actually the challenge, because even if the city council buy the villa, the dimension of the city council and the budget that they have yearly actually is really small. So there is, of course, the need to expand the management and expand the number of organization and people involved on the future of the villa. So for this reason, we think that we should create regional, national, and international dimension, and engage people at this different level simultaneously. And this is what actually mainly we think we can bring by create this connection with CivicWise, and the first connection promoted by Volume. So I mentioned that there is a local organization, an NGO, but also the partnership with Volume, that is already an international organization, is spreading and create this international connection. And today with CivicWise is the idea that even broadens this connection. So more pictures. So you start maybe to see more and more. So as you can see, when we say Italian villa, I don't know what you have in mind, but maybe some of you thought that it's only a building. Actually, it's not. Connection between 30 buildings. So all the buildings you see in the picture are part of the villa. So it's 5 hectares, so a lot of square meters built, and this is also part of it is protected as cultural heritage. Yes, so the villa is in good state, but is not something that you can use right away. You buy it. This is also another important thing to take in account. So there is the little garden that also is a duty for the owner to maintain it, and actually right now is really well maintained, is the part that is most well maintained. The rest of the buildings, they are not in ruin, but to be legally used, they need some job, and this is also really expensive as well. So later when we be thinking about what we can do with the villa, the most important part is think how actually we could, because it's hypothetical for now, we could use it activating processes while actually we will be doing these works. So maybe activating some little part of the villa and creating activities there, and then step by step, creating the economical circle that give us the resources and the energy to continue with the process to activate all the part, all not the whole the whole villa. So this is the garden is really really beautiful and really typical of this Renaissance era. Some picture. So this is the villa is also situated in a really interesting region in Italy called Marche. That last year was also nominated by Lonely Planet as the second most interesting region in the world to be visited. And it's really, really beautiful, you know, with a lot of hill and really beautiful landscape. So let's go to what we could do, what we would like to do with this villa. So first of all, the idea is that we would like to promote a sort of a co-design prefiguration process that give us the definition of what we will do there. This is really important. So the idea, so for now, Volume and Ville, that are already working together and connecting with local and global communities, we are not promoting a final solution. So, you know, this kind of architectural definition and closed program, you know, defined and really precise activities or, you know, business plan. But first, we think we should promote a process to actually get together the different stakeholders and community, thinking on how we could work together and how we can get real sustainability to this huge villa. So for it, we are promoting a process. This is one of the milestones of this process. Yesterday we had another one, really important. So I think the first one was the creation of the organization, Ville. You can visit even the site. I don't know if you had the opportunity. I will put here the link. Then the connection with Volume. Then we create a Facebook group that has already 400 people engaged. This is mainly local group that is really important because I think helped to increase the awareness of this villa with local community. So yesterday we had the first public presentation with a webinar in Italian, and was really good. A lot of good vibes and energy. And then we have today another important milestone because this is the first international presentation. So this process will be continuing. Let's see. Sorry, I forgot to put. Okay. So this process will be continuing with other events. So we think that maybe in the middle of July we will have an first insight meeting with local community, and then at the end of July we will have a sort of summer camp. I will talk about it later, And I guess that will be the occasion to promote a last energy before the auction that is scheduled for the end of the July. So is when maybe we will have some buyers at the end of July that buy the villa. So for this process, we would like to promote a different approach that usually we can hear mainly locally, but I think is something that happened even globally. So this idea that when we talk about heritage, about this kind of buildings, we are we could have people that prefer to understand it mainly as part of a unique field. So this field could be culture. Other people think, no, this is more for tourism. Others say, no, this is an opportunity for entrepreneurship. On other, they say, no, this is something that is owned, should be owned by the community. So the first important part is that. So for us, we can see that for us is all of them, and even others that we are not maybe taking account in this at this moment in this presentation. So we think that the opportunity to get future to the villa and enrich actually local and global community is includes all of these approaches. So, and for this is really important inclusivity and hybridization. So about the timeline, so I was saying, so at the 28th of July, there is the auction. When we created the NGO, Ville, the situation was different. So the auction was planned to be at the end of the year. And we were even thinking about some possibility to buy the villa. To give you an order of dimension of the money need for the villa, actually the price is reducing anytime the auction gets empty. So I don't know, each 6 months or something like that, each year. From some time now, there is this try to sell the villa, and each time there is no buyer, the price is increasing. So now the price, more or less, is €2 million to buy the all. So of course to activate it, there is the need for much more money. So it's why it's important also to think about the process to get real the activation. So what happened? Actually, finally, the auction was changed, and they put the date in the end of July. So actually, we don't have time to, we were thinking maybe start a sort of crowdfunding, global crowdfunding, claiming for this Italian villa with maybe a lot of people in the world interested in this, spot of hope, even during the COVID pandemic. So giving this window for, global and local community. And we thought that it's a lot of money, but maybe we can reach easier a really global community, and so get the money. Now, to the end of July, we think that we are not in time. Then we can think about it, because maybe you have some crazy idea or opportunity that maybe tell us that we are still in time to to find this money. Anyway, the idea is, even if we are not able to buy the villa, we want to have a word on the future of the villa. And so why is why we are moving now really fast to activate some action. And because we think now we can put together different stakeholders, maybe have some first ideas about what we can do there, but so to show up before the sale of the villa, that there is already some people there that are really engaged with it. So when we have the buyers, so we think that the buyer couldn't avoid talk with us about what we can do in the villa. This is the strategy, let's say. So even after the buy of the villa, we think we can continue with ideation and prefiguration of what we can have in the villa and be part of the, some management of part of the villa. Mainly, so we can say that we would like to promote a new rural and connected hub to think, experiment, and build tomorrow's worlds. So why this slogan? Because actually what is really important, maybe I didn't emphasize so much so far, but it's important to say that maybe in the picture you already realized it, this is a really rural area. So it's not a villa, you know, that is in urban area. It's a rural area, and this is a small town. It's true that it's really close actually to the beach. This is also interesting, and in this really beautiful region in Italy. So it's important to think how we can create something relevant in this rural area. That could be connected with other interesting projects in the region, in the you know, in Italy and in the rest of the Europe and the world. For this, we promote some axes, no, some important topic that we think we can bring value to the project. So as you know, we are thinking now that all of this villa, the 30 buildings, the garden, could be part of a productive and creative hub. So, and what is a productive and creative hub is also a connection between those characteristics and those topics. So innovation, education, circular economy, inclusion, and heritage. Again, this is important for us, not focus only in one direction, try to connect different approaches. This is also a good moment because Europe, you may know, with the new Bauhaus, the new European Bauhaus promoted by Europe, there is important, there are different dynamics that are putting both the idea that there are important buildings, locations, like hubs. Actually, the idea that the design is an opportunity for community, but also something that is one of the best value that we promoted in Europe. So there is this campaign that maybe we can promote again this protagonism in design, better connected with the local community. So with this program, there is the idea to promote pilot projects in different EU states, where actually this, you know, creative dynamic will be connected with local communities, like, let's say, Bauhaus, did in the past. And actually, we think that this villa could be one of these places in Europe, and we think that we are well placed to achieve that. Another important information for you is what we are doing with volumes. Because at volumes, we are part of this European project called Centrino, and we are working on actually how a new industrial revolution could put citizens in the heart of a sustainable transformation. So this is an important asset now because, we are already participating in this dynamic. I can share with you a short video. Just a moment. I will share. I don't know, I didn't test before. I hope it works. You can hear or not? Just to test. You heard something or not?
No, nothing.
Nothing. Yeah, so...
Domenico, you can try maybe if you go to the three dots that you can see down right.
Yeah.
You will see an option which is share a YouTube video.
Okay, great.
I think that is going to work.
Centrino is a research project focused on historical industrial sites across 9 European cities. Centrino will transform them into sustainable and inclusive hubs for its residents by bringing urban regeneration solutions and innovative strategies.
You are mute.
Okay, thanks Pascual. I learned something new. It's really really good how it's improving Jitsi. So let's continue. Okay, so I hope it's the image you watched in the video, I think already told you a lot about this Centrino project. The interesting thing is that so with volumes that we have already a lot of experience in Paris because we started activating a first creative and productive hub in Paris more than 5 years ago, I guess now. And now actually, even in Paris, this space is connecting with other space. So we are creating there a sort of productive and creative ecosystem in the East area of Paris that was and still a little, still is the poorest area, if we can say this, talking about Paris, but the city, I mean, inside the city. So it's not the richest part of Paris, and we are proud that we are part of a bunch of dynamics, activities, stakeholders that in this area create something really valuable. So an ecosystem that is creating positive impact, connecting entrepreneurships, designers, NGO, city council, so together to create, you know, how to promote a good transformation of the area. So now we have the opportunity with Centrino to work on the creation of the same seed in 9 cities in Europe. So this is really exciting. You can see Tallinn, Copenhagen, Amsterdam, Paris, Geneva, Milan, Zagreb, Barcelona. So it's interesting because actually we are trying now to, while we are building it, we are also creating a sort of guidelines of how you can start a creative and productive hub. So this is inside the DNA of Volume and also of CivicWise. So this idea to, you know, get into the action and learn by doing, and try to then define a sort of methodology that you can reproduce, even if you have to change and improve anytime, is anyway giving you some guidelines to go ahead in another situation or to improve the same project. So actually, what we are doing now, so we have 9 pilot cities for that. We are adding a new one, and guess which one? So the villa. So we already moved to include in this European project, a new pilot that could be the villa. We are still working on it, but it's something that will be easy there. The partner of the consortium, the European consortium, actually received with a goodwill this proposal, because actually I have to say that personally I am learning a lot from European projects. I don't know if you had or have the same common idea, that maybe European projects are not useful or maybe really far to everyday life and citizens. But really, I'm discovering with this Centrino project that is an opportunity, and huge opportunity, to really promote innovation and concrete action for this amazing connection between, you know, great ideas and local communities. And with this Centrino is something that is happening, and one of the aim, not the goal of this project, is actually that what we are doing, what we are testing, could spread, it could be useful for other projects. So actually, when we propose the idea to include this new pilot, the rest of the consortium were really happy, because actually is in a way the evidence that the project is having success, because it's useful what we are doing with this European project. So this is really good news, because when we will achieve to have this European flag, let's say, for this pilot, we know that a lot of new resources and opportunity could be available. So Centrino, you can see here, is a consortium of a lot of organization. So it's coordinated by Comune di Milano, funded by Europe, coordinated by FabLab Barcelona and IAC. And then there are a lot of, main partners, and Volume is there. Fab City Paris as well, and there are, you know, really well-known organization. Maybe you know Pakhuis de Zwijger in Amsterdam, WAG de Amsterdam. Yeah, so really, really interesting, rich, rich contest to learn. So I don't want to go too much in details with Centrino, but so with this European project, we are, as I said, creating guidelines, tools, toolkits that will help the activation of these creative and productive hubs. They are also connected with the Fab City Foundation, Fab City Initiative, that may you already know. So, you know, like this full stack strategy promoted by Fab City Initiative. So yeah, I think I don't want to go in this detail, but you know, anytime there is this idea that so here the idea that we should be aware of about how we manage you know, energy, waste, materials, and create, let's say, in a simple way, a circular economy. Avoid this situation where actually metropolis and territories are receiving materials that are treated, used, and then they are just becoming garbage, with this idea that not only what we receive in a territory could be reused, but also that the same habitat could create locally resources. So yeah, and the idea that this is could be more sustainable, and with the digital era, is easier to get traveling information, not products. So I guess you are already familiar with all of this. And then we reach the most important part. So I mentioned that we are planning to organize a summer camp here. Actually, I don't know if I said, but I am now living. I moved for 6 months now, really close to the villa, for also for this reason. I'm feel now really close to this this project, and so we are organizing for the 23 and 24 July a summer camp. Will be an event where we will be working on the prefiguration, pre-design proposals for what we can do in the villa. But also, it's also a strategical event that want to put us in the center of the common, I would say, opinione pubblica, public opinion. So this is the 23rd and 24th. The cell will be the 28th. So the idea is that we want to highlight and give visibility to the community we are building, and the initial ideas and proposal we could have, in order to get the attention of local media, and also let clearly know to the new buyers, and mainly also the local the city council, that we are ready, we are there, we are already moving without any need for, you know, specific mandate, I don't know how to say. So the idea will be that the 23rd, we will have three or four work groups working in inside and online sessions. So the idea is to have an hybrid day that, you know, allow us to be connected with global community like you, but also local community. And actually, you are invited. So if you want to come and be part of this workshop locally, the 23rd and 24th, you are welcome. So let us know, and we can see how we can help you with just some noise. Sorry. How we can help you? To be accommodate, and so let us know. Maybe after this workshop, you will be motivated to participate. I hope at least online, or if you feel motivated online here in the region. So the 23rd will be mainly, you know, a work session, a multi work session day, and then the 24th. Will be the day where actually we will be showing up this initial idea to the local community, and you know, promote some visits on the villa, and also invite the local media in order to, you know, to have this presence on local media before the sale. So actually the 23rd will be, you know, something with maybe not a lot of people, because mainly we will be working, and the 24th is more oriented to, you know, general public, and get as much visibility we can. So we'll be inviting all local community. We already started. So the city council, for instance, is already informed that we will be doing that. And we hope a lot of people can reach the villa this day, the 24th. So this will be the summer camp. As I said before, this locally we will be organizing maybe another insight meeting, just to get more people locally engaged. And help us to organize even this summer camp. And the idea is that this summer camp will be also confirming the partners like CivicWise. So Volume is doing already a lot of job, you know, even you know, thinking on some resources to promote this event. But the idea is that this could be, you know, fostered by other partners. So there is so CivicWise, also Airbnb Coop, that maybe you already know. So Airbnb Coop is an online platform that is creating an alternative for vacational rental platform. Is a cooperative, and is really, you know, connected with this process, because promotes regenerative economy, so which is really connected with circular economy, because the platform don't allow any speculation with housing, and also the 50% of the revenue is distributed to local projects. So we see that the, you know, the connection with this project is also really really powerful. And then I already mentioned this Centrino, so how we can include this in the consortium. We have other to be confirmed, like the city council. They are informed, but just informed. And then there is also the Fab City initiative that may be also informed, and we will see if they finally can support the event. So yeah, I already said that this is really important. Why we are doing this event? Not just to insist, is not only think on what we can do, but it also create this awareness locally and globally. So if we get attention from media, we hope we can have a good impact also on the behavior of the buyer. If we don't decide to organize some crazy dynamic to collect the money ourselves. So this is, we could share, maybe Cenk, you can talk about this.
Yes, sure. This is a quite tiny bit of funding for an on-site event that will organized by Villa NGO, and also Volumes Paris will be the collaborator of the project. And we have this budget for the travel costs and also some of the accommodation required for the on-site event that we planned as an excursion for the villa and its transformation into a fab lab. And this hope to have an outcome as a manual, which can be also used in similar rural spaces and heritage sites, which potentially can become totally or as part or partially into a creative hubs. So this is like a quite tiny bit of budget, but it also has not a theoretical or online event, but it will also direct attention to the site itself. And also it will, it hope to bring visibility to the newly created NGO and also to the heritage site internationally. Hopefully this will also interest you in a way.
Thanks, Cenk. Yes, this is another example, as you said, that when you start moving and you are well connected with what is happening right now, is easier to, you know, to go ahead with the process. So why I'm saying that, because maybe to someone could seem a really crazy idea that we, you know, you approach this huge villa, but actually it's just a matter to create synergies between different organization, projects, stakeholders, etc. No, alone you can do that, but with, you know, a lot of people we can. So that's all for now. So now, yeah, I guess you have some question in order to understand better what it is, what we can do. So I will open for Q&A, no, for question, and then if there is still time, we can maybe have some kind of short workshop thinking on some actions or references, activities, campaign idea to go ahead. So I will stop to share. No, I wasn't sharing actually so far.
Yeah, you were sharing.
And now no.
No.
I go. So, do you have any question?
Just feel free.
Cenk, do you want to add something that I maybe forgot?
No, actually, it was quite complete with all details. But the interesting part of all of these projects and the NGO is it's quite newly created and things are going faster than we foreseen. So as Domenico mentioned during the presentation, it ought to happen, that auction ought to happen at the end of the 2021. But then, in the middle of the summer, all of a sudden it had to be done. It will be done. So in a way, all discussions started as a kind of crazy romantic idea to transform that villa into an oasis for creative people, whoever want to come and do something, and then, I don't know, maybe not necessarily putting there something much and then go with good memories and some kind of creative inspiration and go. But then the monetary issue is a big thing, as Domenico mentioned. But this restriction also brought this idea of sharing the management plan with more stakeholders if they are also willing to, because this was also a discussion in the NGO. What will the role of NGO be? Such as, you know, the main manager of the whole site, which is responsible for the restoration, for the management, for the maintenance of the garden, and anything. But then we thought, like, oh, maybe this will be a little bit difficult because we are only 6 or 5, Domenico. So this will be a big problem. But then having some kind of private initiators, like companies, I don't know, individuals, who will be the partners of the whole idea, it can be also quite interesting, we thought. And maybe this restriction in time forced us to get into action. And because of that decision, right now we are having this public discussions. And yesterday it was in Italian, maybe only 10% that I understood. But at the end, people were quite motivated and sharing lots of ideas. That's why I thought, like, it was really good. And today with you, and hopefully with these events that will take place in the villa, they will create more attention, because online events can gather lots of people together and will be quite motivational to invent ideas. But at the end, if we can gather on site, then it will be much more the message will be much more powerful, and also maybe more people from the local community have more motivation to be a part of it, or at least to get into the at least to be a part of the discussions, which will also increase the importance of this initiative for the local political stakeholders, and also for the possible buyers. That's why it's quite interesting. It's shaping quite fast. And if you have some similar experiences or non-similar experiences, but which will put some kind of, you know, clearance in our methodology, it will be also great to hear right now. So please share.
I have a question. I don't know if it's a silly question, maybe, and maybe you already said it, Domenico, but who are you imagining this villa for? I mean, let's imagine you made it and you build this creative hub. Which kind of people are you imagining using that creative hub? Is it going to be local people, citizens, associations, people coming from abroad? Because I mean, it's huge. There are 30 buildings. I don't know. I don't know how is the context. So, which kind of people are you imagining using the kind of program in that specific context?
Yeah, I think we could have different ideas. So, as I said, for us, the most important is to start the process. But of course, we can have in some you know, initial scenario in mind. So first of all, I would insist that this is a rural area. So around the villa, there are, I mean, the most important dynamics are. So during the summer, this is, you know, a beach destination. Then another characteristics. So the hill, they are, you know, a lot of agriculture production. So it's not industrial production, but anyways, organized and well, you know, well, with, is not familiar just, you know, for own production. There is, you know, important production agriculture, for agriculture. Then other topic is this is this region was really in the past was really industrial for shoes. So was the area where actually the Italian shoes were produced. So you have a lot of industrial buildings that are now empty. For instance, we have a good relationship with some people that converted, you know, heritage in new activities that are emerging now, for instance, co-living, no, or co-working. So you have old buildings that need to be reconverted in something new. So this shoes activity now is really, you know, reduced, and in some way there is a need for something new, so new development opportunities, and we think that the villa could be, you know, the icon of this new, let's say, renaissance. so this is important, no? So the how you create attention and hope, of course, should be sustained by something concrete, but this is also interesting because the dimension is enough to promote something relevant for all these activities. So agriculture, a new, let's say, creative work in the sense of, you know, creative people now are moving from cities to maybe more rural area, and this is rural area but not really, you know, disconnected from the rest of the world, so in the middle of Italy. So this is important that you could be easily connected with big cities like Bologna, Roma, you know, Firenze, Milan, so this is also useful. So, and to be concrete, we see that with these 30 buildings, you can approach different area. So one, of course, is agriculture. Actually, there is a big building that has that was used in the past also as a place where you collect, you know, agriculture production. So this is, you know that in agriculture, what is really valuable is when you transform the basic production in something new, because the only production, unfortunately, is not giving a lot of money. So anytime you can treat and, you know, transform the basic production, you can give value to this production, so you can give more money. And anytime you can reduce, you know, the intermediaries between the buyers and the producers, of course you can give it, you are giving more money to the producers, and actually the price will be reduced by the buyers. So to transform this, that now include a lot of intermediaries, that you have big company that are you know, doing all this treatment, you need the attention. So you need a place where people go and then can discover the products, etc., so they can buy it, etc. So this is something that is really valuable. So if we create attention to this place for the whole region and even internationally, we are creating the enough audience to activate this innovation in agriculture. And what is interesting is that that could be connected with other activities. One, I mentioned, one is culture. So the place is really beautiful and is really able to host cultural events. To a global, from a global camp to you know, any I don't know, music, theater, you know, dance. So it's really, so this is so you have the opportunity to connect cultural world with agricultural world. And then you have the creative world in the sense of, you know, designers, makers, etc. So we can bring some, you know, some first machines in order to produce, maybe use the knowledge that the area has with the shoes production, transforming it in something different, no? Because there is some knowledge about how to work with specific materials for shoes that maybe now is not sustainable because shoes are produced cheaper elsewhere, but maybe we can, you know, use it for in a different way. Then there is all the this world of co-living and co-working that we don't know yet how will be changing, but there is something that I didn't mention that is crazy, is that between these 30 buildings there are houses adosados. I don't know how to say in English, Pasquale, maybe you know. Casa schiera per gli italiani.
I don't remember now.
So there is an area, actually the previous owner was trying to get money building this this familiar house that give you your own house just aside to others. So you have several private house, one after others. I don't know how to say in English. Yeah, so they built I don't know how much, maybe 10 or 12, I don't remember, and they are almost ready. So you have even houses inside this, so you can live there. So this is also interesting. Actually, you can create a community that is living there. So this community could be a stable community that is living there, you know, the family, but maybe also you could have this temporary, you know, approach. So maybe people that come to live 6 months, for instance, like I'm doing now here. I don't know what you think, but it seems that it's something that will be happening more and more. Instead of doing this crazy trip where you go for a weekend in you know, the opposite you know, of the world. You I don't know how many miles you do to visit just one city. I guess now, I don't know, maybe I'm wrong, but there are some evidence that we are going towards this direction. We can have more this type of workation. Have you heard about it? The workation. So you melt vacation with working. So actually you travel and you go in a city and you stay there maybe 3 months and you still work on a cloud. So you are a digital nomad, no? You know. And you just want to avoid that anytime you reach a new city, you have to prepare everything in the house, no? So you go and you have everything set. And also what we are looking for with this dynamic is the opportunity to be connected with interesting community. So, if we think in what we did in Paris, so in Paris, there are these spaces. When you visit these spaces, even if you are not part of this community, what you feel is that when you go there and you know more or less these design communities, you know that when you go there, you have really a good chance to meet interesting people, interesting projects. But for instance, then you can't live there. No, there is not a place where to live. Here, you could have even this. So the possibility to live in this space connected with different dynamics and also this diversity. So not only, you know, designers community, but also, you know, as I mentioned, cultural activities, agriculture activities. So this is so in terms of economical sustainability, of course, the thing is that we can't have all of this from start, from scratch. That's the challenge. We have to create this step by step, maybe starting from something, from some of them, and be, you know, strategic, understanding which action could create the best starting effect that encourage all the other dynamic coming, you know. But I know that it seems still really generic, but this is the challenge.
Domenico, I have
I can ask something.
Mm-hmm. Sorry.
I'm going to cut my camera because I think when I put my camera, the connection is kind of bad. So this is Begonia Alonso, and I've been really interested on your project, Domenico, because actually I'm trying to do something similar in Spain, in a small village. And I want to ask you something. Domenico, how many people are working with you? What's the legal frame for this action? Are you kind of association, or how does it work? What's the legal frame?
Yes, as I mentioned, so we have an association called Ville. So I shared with you the link. So maybe Cenk, you can share again in the chat. So this is the starting point. This is an association, so a non-profit organization. In this non-profit organization, we are six. And this is the, you know, the starting point promoting any connection locally. So this is the legal part. So the dialogue we have, I didn't mention actually so far, we already started a talk with the city council. So the start of this, we start even before the creation. So actually the initial promoter of this is Francesco Cingolani. He is from this area. So he lived actually 50 meters from the villa. So he grow actually a site in the same place of the villa. So he's starting 10 years ago even talking about it. And he is also one of the promoters of Volume. So he started talking also with the city council. Then he promotes this idea to create an NGO connecting with me, with Jenk and other. So me and Jenk and also Claire Sophie, I guess. Jenk, we are the people that are not from the area. And the other members are from the area. So the idea was that we create the association from scratch with this global approach, no? Global people and also local people. So this is the legal frame. And so this association is now having a dialogue with the city council. And we had the opportunity also to participate in the official meeting with city council that now are confirmed that will be happening any with the regular time. And then, you know, taking advantage with the fact that from the promoters of this organization, we are also part of other organization that has a lot of experience in this kind of dynamic. Which is Volume, which is Airbnb, and also today I would push as much as possible in the CivicWise network. There are a lot of people that are also familiar with this. So now CivicWise is the first time we are connected. So the idea is from this association work to connect all of these skills, organization, put them together and together create a sort of consortium that could act on the villa. I don't know if it's clearer now, Begonia.
Yeah, it's very clear. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Johannes,
Johannes here. Hello. Thank you very much for the presentation, and it's a very interesting project you presented. I just wanted to add, it remembered me on a project I got to know here in Germany, where which is a little bit similar, because they wanted to buy or activate a theater in the middle of the city, a theater which was abandoned for many years, and they started to create a cooperative, and only the people who or to be part of the cooperative, you had to buy a share, and one share was 1,000 euro in this case. And so they could, and you could, the share or your membership in the cooperative could also be an NGO, an organization, and so on. And with these shares, collected the money they needed. It was in this case 1 million euro to get a credit from a bank and to start the renovation of the theater, and later to activate it as a cultural space. And they reached it in this way. Maybe it just came in my mind. Maybe it's an idea to, when it comes to, negotiate with the buyer or something like that. Maybe it might be a part of a model to think about in terms of. Getting the money together, but also to activate the community, because once you got involved in this way, you can activate also companies, or as you said, the shoe industry, if there's still some companies left or something like that. Well, any people who want to be part of this project, that they participate also in a share of money, and so start to get a little financial basis. Yeah, just as an idea to what I know from this project.
Yes, it's really interesting. Actually, if in July there will be no buyers, so the scenario will be open to actually go in this kind of approach. So Cenk, I don't know if you have other comment.
It's quite interesting. Can you do you remember the name of the theater or at least the association so we can also check further?
Yeah, of course. I can share the link, but I think it's only in German.
Okay.
I can share the link, yes.
Danke sehr.
So actually we are managing even crazy ideas. So if you want to open also to crazy ideas, I can share it with you. So yesterday, Francesco was sharing a crazy idea that I think could be maybe a great approach. So Francesco yesterday was suggesting, why not start from now, right now, a campaign with this slogan. So we are looking for rich people to save a villa, something like that. What will be the dynamic? Actually, the idea is to look for some rich people that will donate 3 million euro to the organization, to the association. So with this money, the 28th July, we go to the auction and we buy the villa. And why this could be understood as really crazy, but not really, because of course in the world there are people that 3 million is nothing. All the time, the question is, how we reach these people and why these people should be interested in doing that. Because now, for instance, there are some buyers, we discovered that there are some buyers that want to buy the villa for themselves. They want to create their own villa. They want to know nothing about the community, etc. Because for them, you know, 2 million euros is nothing. So the idea is, if we now, that is also pandemic time, and so there is this need for hope and see something different, we can create a sort of tam-tam, not a sort of communication, that there are crazy people that want to meet rich people to have the money to buy a villa. It's easier, because it's easier than look for, you know, let's say 10,000 people that put, I don't know, now the numbers, 500 euros. Is something that we think that we can achieve, of course, but not in a month, because you need a lot of work to prepare that. In the opposite, if we should look for, you know, one or some people that put practically the whole amount of money, is easier, because you can find easily the help of a lot of people that share the message. Because it's easier, you know, when you hear the news, there are these crazy people that are looking for richer that they can put the money. So they share the information. And we think that we can go easily in the newspaper, in the, you know, in the media, with this, you know, crazy idea that we are looking for richest people to put the money. And if this campaign reach, you know, a lot of, you know, spread a lot for richer people, there are more interest to, you know, to be part of this, because maybe for them it's not a lot. So the idea, yeah, so this is one crazy idea we, Francesco had, and I really liked that we could do. And this actually, if we don't get these richer people, of course we will have a lot of publicity, because all around the world, I think people could heard about this villa in Italy that could be saved only for 2,000 2 million euro, no? And that could have could give us new opportunity to later doing something with the final buyer, or I don't know, maybe organize what Johannes said, a cooperative, you know. So this is the kind of crazy idea that we also could start. I don't know what you think of this.
But then I have a question. There's a chance that in July, a buyer appear, buy the villa, and then the project is gone?
Yes.
Okay.
There is. There is. Right now, seems to be the less possible, but there is this possibility. Is why, so we know that there is this possibility, but it's not the most probable. Is why we think it's important now to make noise and to, you know, to show up and organize everything, because if now is already something that is not the most probable, if we make this noise, we think that we even reduce the possibility for that. But nothing can avoid that could happen, because it's a sell. So.
If there's no buyer, then the villa is going to be for city council, or?
No, so the one of the buyers could be the city council.
Okay.
So the city council, I didn't mention this. So we also think that because the city council is looking for money. So far for was too expensive, so they never thought that they could buy it. But now that it's cheaper, so 2,000 million, they have started, okay, maybe we can buy it. The problem is, okay, we buy it, but what do we do with it? So actually, we also think that if we can show that there is local community, global community, different stakeholders, this connection with the European project, so we can show that there are already dynamics that could easily happen there, is more feasible from the city council to buy the villa, because they can say, okay, there is something already happening, we are not buying this and then we don't know what we do with it, no? So it's also another reason why we really push this, and for us would be the best scenario. See, the best scenario would be that the city council buy the villa. This is,
totally.
So we are pushing, of course, for us. There will be also the situation that nobody again will buy the villa. In this case, there will be another sale, maybe, I don't know, in 6 months, or we don't know, with a cheaper price. And we know that, of course, at that moment, there will be a buyer. And for instance, for the city council, will be, you know, even cheaper, so the city council could buy it. So still, you know, again, it's interesting to start now with this, to get this presence, you know, this protagonism as well on the process, to be assured that we will be part of the future of the villa.
Yeah, for sure that would be it. As I see it, also the best option with the city council. And try to reach people. I don't know. You can make it. It's also a good option, but I don't know. it's not so much time. It's not just to reach them, it's to convince them. And so I don't know if you have enough time for that. So I don't know if I will try to put all the energy with the city council, trying to for them to be the buyer. And they have the money and the intention to buy it, and you have the know-how. So I would put all the energy on that. Sense.
Yes, we are on it. Of course, it's why we are participating in the conversation, and we are inviting them. But you know, this is
I understand.
And wow. also other thing we are doing, we are trying to connect with the buyers, the people interested in buy, because we want to talk with them before they buy, because there could be other kind of buyers that are maybe funds or other organization that buy it really with most fair attention to heritage, etc. So we are trying to know who will be interested in buying, and also in these events we are planning having the opportunity to talk with them and let them know the people, the community that are now moving on it. So, for instance, I mentioned during the presentation, before the Facebook group, there were some article on newspapers, but the public opinion weren't really expressing or visible. So no, we created the Facebook group. I mean, in a day, we had 300 people, now 400. And now there are a lot of people that are, commenting and hoping and pushing and this is already a message. This is already, a first goal we achieved. So the public opinion is now feeling that has new channels to be involved. It's also important to mention, and yesterday we also clarified that we are not the organization, Ville, called Ville NGO, is not proposing itself like the representative of all the citizenship. So you, from Civic Quasi, you are already aware about multi-belonging, so I'm not telling you nothing new. But here is really important this, because they are not used to have this approach. And we specify, we are not the representative of the citizenship. We hope other organization could be starting now and collaborating with us. But the aim is to be the promoters and that something will happen. But we don't want to be the representative of the citizenship. And this is important. So we are, creating the multi-belonging, and I don't know, Bendehui is not here, but I have a joke for him because I'm bringing a new concept that I call the autonomous convergence. Autonomous, how is it? Let me know just. No, converging autonomies is my new mantra and my new concept. So it's the idea that what is important is not to get all the people in the same organization or in the same action, but promote that different organization, different dynamics could happen, and they could have autonomy. This is mainly possible if the city council buy it. So they will be the owners, a public owner, and then there will be different initiatives happening there with autonomy. But what we will be promoting and hoping is for not that they could converge. So they have some point of connection that create more value for each initiative. So there is no need to be all in the same boat. Be the same, all of us, but at least be connected. Is at the same time the same message. So we are approaching the end. So I don't know, more comments, questions, ideas. So maybe we can mention also this crazy idea about global camping.
Yeah, I was writing in fact,
about this. Too much connected.
Yeah. Well, just Domenico mentioned at the beginning of the session that this workshop is inside an event. It's the whole day, event. It has different workshops and different project presentations. And just right now at 12 p.m. Madrid time, so in 10 minutes, we are going to have a 1 hour session with three projects presented. A Fab Lab laboratories that Lab Plus, an organization in the French Pyrenees, are building with high school, with five high schools. Another project, which is playmaking, which is a research about how to improve our cities through dynamics of game design, and also Airbnb, that you maybe know it also through Domenico, which is an alternative option for Airbnb. Also built in a cooperative way. So we're going to have that, and then this afternoon we have another two workshops running in parallel. In fact, right now there's another workshop at the same time here with Domenico. There's another workshop in another room. So this afternoon is going to be the same, two parallel workshops, and then another three project talks. So if you want to join, I'm going to share here the whole program in case you want to join the project presentation on the workshop or the workshop for this afternoon. You have the whole program there, and to join you have to go to this link. Once you get there, don't panic because you're going to see it's like a video game. We built like a space, because GlocalCamp is the regular meeting that Civic West community used to gather the whole community to, and it's a face-to-face event, but this year for obvious reasons we couldn't make it to the face-to-face. So we built a space with different rooms in which you can explore the space, and you can it's not just to share content through these workshops and through project presentations, but to meet people, to try to meet people, connect with people, and just to talk with them. And so that's why we build this strange video game space. So once you go to that link, you have to choose an avatar, choose a name. You're going to appear in a video game atmosphere. You can move your avatar with the arrows of your keyboard and find the room in which you can find the activities. So that's it for me. I don't know if you have any doubt or whatever. You can also contact us through the page of trans.local.com.
Okay, thanks, Pascual. So, last chance to say something. Damien, we didn't hear you.
Exactly. I listen all of you, what you say. It's very exactly a huge project. There is so much thing to do in this project. I can't talk about that. I would like to go to this camp in July. I don't know if I'm free, but I have to check it. But I'm so motivated to participate, but I don't know in which domain. Yes, I will think about that. Because your presentation was important to understand it, and my brain will work now.
Okay, great. Yeah, I take advantage to remember. Really, if some of you are interested in come personally, let us know. Yeah. Let us know, because we want to have of course there are online sessions, but in site is much better. So let us know and we can see how we can arrange that. So to close, I would propose maybe you can help me, Pascual, maybe make a final picture with a screenshot with all the participants. Karine. Hello, Karine.
Bonjour.
Bonjour.
It's nice to see you. Yeah.
We are finishing this and then we start with the others. So if you want, switch on the camera and we are taking the final picture. Maybe we can...
Like that?
We can invent a gesture. I don't know if you have some idea. Instead of the same... Three. who is taking the screenshot?
I am.
Okay.
Okay.
You did?
Yes, I have it.
Okay. Thanks to you all. It was amazing to have this opportunity to talk with you. You have the site. Maybe Jeng and me, we can share our email. So you can write us if you have any doubts. We are really excited about this. So let's go ahead. We also have your email, if you don't mind. Maybe we will be sending you news about this project and how maybe you can be, involved, etc. Okay? Perfect. So, Pascual, I don't know how we close.
I think we're going to, I don't know if for the next activity, we're going to be in this room another one. I think we're going to be in this room, so if you want to stay for the next activity, you can just stay here. I'm going to try to reach the rest of the people, and I'll be back in 1 minute.
Okay. Thanks.
Thank you all.
I'm going, everyone. I will come back.
Okay.
Ciao, Jeff. Yeah. Thanks.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Ciao.
Thank you very much. Ciao.
Ciao, ciao.
Bye-bye. Adios.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Ciao.